at the home of the Super Bowl 52 champions, Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, PA. The scene in South Philly a few moments ago. Boy, the city of brotherly love is fired up. They're saying fly, Eagles, fly as they get ready to match up with the Buffalo Bills. Here's the kicker, Jake Elliott, ready to get this one started. And off we go from Lincoln Financial Field. And we will not see a run back on the opening kickoff. This will be a touchback. To the 34. But you often say that sort of opens the playbook now, second and short. What do you think, early shot here?
I like where you're going. Obviously, we've been together for a while because you know me. I want to take that shot early and loosen things up.
The last run got 9. That leaves him with 2nd and a yard. Going to give this one to Singletary. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44.
How best to describe that one? I'd say right down Broadway on that run.
A straight ahead running. I think that might be something we see a lot of between the tackles today.
Well, he's enjoying things so far here this afternoon. Sees a crease and bursts through it for a solid gain.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. On play action, Allen. That's caught by his tight end, Dawson Knox. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35.
Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. I don't think you can get much more balance than this. Big time run, big time pass.
A 1-2 combination. Looked pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
So from Philadelphia territory now, here's a 1st and 10 at the 36. Pressure comes and down he goes. The Eagles get the outside. Davion Taylor just would not be denied. That's a loss of 7. Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on 2nd down. Another try after the 1st down sack. Allen, he's got it complete to Stephon Diggs. And all the way home for a Bills touchdown. Stephon Diggs, 43 yards. And the Bills have taken the early lead. Well, that's how they envisioned it, get the football to start the game and score it.
And I don't know if that was scripted, was it an audible, or was it just a play call that they had in their pocket. No matter what, they had the right call on against the right defense, and they end up in the end zone.
And now Sean McDermott's made the call. They'll go for 2. And he will get in to make it 8-0. So what do you make of that? You go on the road, you score the opening drive touchdown, opt to go for 2, and all of a sudden they're up 8-0.
Yeah, this wasn't a decision that they made right here and right now. They made this decision during the week. Hey, if we get the ball and score right away, let's show them that we feel like we're superior. Go for 2 and really put the pressure on them.
Thank you. Hurts and the Eagles come up here first and 10 at their 25-yard line. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Open man, that's Devontae Smith. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Now, Charles, what's the mindset here offensively? You gave up a touchdown pretty quickly. Would it have changed if you had gotten a stop and it would be 0-0 right now, or no?
I wouldn't think so. I think in most cases, just down a touchdown, you know, I mean, we're just getting started here. It should be a long way to go. You think to yourself, stick with the game plan, all the things you worked on in practice. But you have some teams that when they get down, their natural tendency is to aggressively strike back. And let's see if they want to get outside of the game plan we expect and try and be aggressive on their first series.
Throwing again on second down, Hurts. And that's complete to Sanders. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45.
Well, they've certainly done a nice job spreading the ball around on this drive. This time he gets it out to his back, and it's another nice play and another first down. They've got the defense on their heels a little bit. They're reacting instead of being aggressive and making plays.
And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far at second down. Close there. He caught it, just wasn't able to stay in bounds.
And that's where the sideline, it was used as a 12th defender. You know, 11's legal. This one is an imaginary one, one that my college coach used to call Sammy Sideline. Sammy Sideline can protect you at times, and in this case, that's exactly what he did for the defenders.
Hurts throw here taken in as he's able to find Goddard. And he's got a first down as the tackle made at the Bills' 30.
And what a nice example there of a tight end doing exactly what he needs to do. How about how he worked his way to the outside, made sure he secured the catch, and then anything after that, we count that as a bonus. And indeed, he gets enough for the first down.
Miles Sanders, first carry of the game. The tackle is made by Micah Hyde.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. He wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
One quarter down, 8-0 the score. Second down, back to Sanders. And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line.
Yeah, once more, strong running. Excellent blocking at the point of attack. They've got a nice little drive brewing right here.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Sanders. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and 2.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Miles Sanders. A 12-yard touchdown run. And the Eagles move back within a couple of the lead. Now that Eagle offense will stay out there as he'll go for two. Check. They'll try and run it up the middle. And he'll get into the end zone as the two-point conversion is successful. Too hot to handle as it will skip through the end zone for a touchback here. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They may have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out.
They'll break the huddle, come up on second and eight at the 27-yard line. Allen off the play fake. And that is knocked away in the middle of the field and incomplete. Defensively, Charles, they continue to really limit this offense as far as yardage goes.
Yeah, you're exactly right. They've been assignment sound, staying in their lanes, keeping proper leverage, and communicating well, too.
So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves him staring up here at a third and eight. Throwing now is Allen. Steps away. It's Knox, the tight end, making the catch. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down. A gain of eight there on the play, and that's going to bring up a fourth down. For it with Breida. And he's going to have a Bills first down as he'll get this up to about the 42.
We're all still valiantly searching for the so-called book, right, that tells us what to do in every situation. Everyone kind of knows what it says, but it's never really been written down anywhere. He violated every code on that one, didn't he? Deciding to go for it right there.
Oh, yeah. Your side of the field, this stage of the game, you're supposed to punt the football. He said, who cares? I'm going to light the book on fire.
Yeah, analytics, everyone else, be warned. He's coming for you.
All tied up, eight apiece with 2 minutes on the clock. Remind you in just a couple of minutes, we'll get you to Orlando and our good friend Jonathan Coachman. Coach will run through some of the numbers and the next gen stats from this first half of football so far. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot downfield because he feels like he can come back on third down and pick up the first down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are, stay with who you know, and go get the first down. That's exactly what they did.
That boy showing how tough he can be to bring down, just fighting his way forward to pick up 7 yards.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
And oh, his first carry, he loses the football. And it's picked up by the Eagles. And they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line. Well, he's not the starter coming in, getting his first carry off.